the big disruption, to use your framing, that a lot of folks are talking about is the rattling of the international liberal world order, which has created a lot of the normative values that have enabled us to avoid the kind of state-to-state conflict that ripped us so apart in the last century. And if you take the way that you're framing it, Colin, and, you know, we're going to move governments aside, we're going to disrupt. I mean, that's not a value-free proposition. And there needs to be a faster pace on creating the values and the normative institutions that would guide that being for good versus the misuse that we do see already in a lot of places. My example about Burma, there's many others. You know, ISIS was a very adept user of technology. And so I would suggest that there needs to be a big hard push on creating the normative value basis, not just a market approach, not just an incentive approach for moving some of these technologies out. Also at a time where we're seeing a steep rise in authoritarian systems. You know, that's going in the wrong direction. We're seeing a closing of democratic space. And as Steve said, the misuse of some of these AI and security technologies to further repress and control the citizenry.